Hi students, let us continue with the concept that is analog to digital conversion interfacing, ADC interfacing. ADC interfacing. So here we have taken the ADC as 0808 or 0809. So this is a pin, the chip we are taking to convert the analog signal to digital signal. The conversion delay for this pin is around 100 microseconds, and whereas the frequency is 640 kilohertz. So I already explained about the pin, just it is a 28 pin dip. It is a 28 pin dip. So this pin will be connected to 8255, which is a programmable. Actually 8255 is programmable peripheral interface. So all the peripheral devices, means the external devices, is connected to 8255, which is acting as an interfacing circuit from microprocessor to, so here the microprocessor 8086 microprocessor, the microprocessor is connected to this programmable peripheral interface. So for this we are connecting the analog digital converter. So whatever the input, the analog input we are giving, analog input, so the input will be first that will be given to the ADC. So this ADC is 080 or 0809. So input we are giving to ADC. So the ADC is connected to the program peripheral interface. So the whatever the input that we are given, that will be converted to digital data, and the digital information will be sent to 8255. So the 8255 will accepting the which is a programmable peripheral interface. So it is an interfacing circuit which acts as an interfacing between the peripheral devices and the 8086. So ADC is nothing but it is a peripheral devices. This is external device. So this 8255 will be send the data to 8086 microprocessor. Then the microprocessor will perform the operation, and again it sends the information to ADC. Okay. So this is just a conversation between ADC and between 8086 microprocessor. Now let us see this block diagram of ADC. Actually this converter, that is the ADC converter, internally has 3:8, internally it has 3:8 analog multiplexers. It is having 3:8 analog multiplexing. So what this 3:8 is, so it's, we are giving 8 different inputs will be there with 3 addresses, 3:8 analog multiplexers, so that at a time 8 different input can be connected to chip. Okay, so this 8 represents 8 different inputs can be connected to this chip. Next, out of these 8 inputs only one can be selected for conversion. Only one can be selected for conversion by using 3 address lines A, B, C. Okay, so with the only out of this total 8 different inputs we are given, so in that only one input can be selected for the conversion by using 3 address lines. With the help of these 3 address lines, one input can be selected, and that input will be first do the conversion. After that, it takes another input with the help of these 3 address lines and convert that input. So one by one it will be take. The CPU may drive these lines using output port lines in case of multi-channel applications. Okay. Now there are different unipolar. There are unipolar A to D converters. They are able to convert analog positive and means analog convert only positive analog input voltage to their digital equivalent. So these chips do not contain any internal sample and hold circuit. The one thing you have to be remember that it does not contain any internal sample and hold circuit. It does not contain any internal sample hole circuit. Okay, so actually we are having 8 analog inputs. Okay, and then address CBA. Suppose analog input 0 is selected. Okay, if you have selected analog input 0, so then the address is based for 0. The 3 address lines consisting of all zeros. If it is IP1, 001, IP2, analog input 2, 010, IP3, 011, IP4, 100. So like that up to IP7, 111. Okay, so based on the analog input signal, based on these address lines, only one bit will be selected at a time. One input will be selected at a time for conversion with the help of this 3 address lines. Now let us see one example. This is an interfacing between ADC to microprocessor. Let us construct an interfacing circuit of ADC to microprocessor. How it is possible? Now let us see the problem. The example is interface analog to digital conversion, that is a 080, or you can take 0809, whatever the ADC you have taken, that should be interfaced with 8086 microprocessor with the help of 8255 ports. So you have to interface this ADC circuit to microprocessor with the help of only 8255, that is a programmable peripheral interface. So with the help of 8255 PPI, you are connecting ADC with 8086 microprocessor. So this programmable peripheral interface consisting of 3 ports. Port C, port B, port A. So 8255 is consisting of 3 ports. So we are just selecting one port here. Use port A of 8255 for transferring digital data output of ADC to CPU. So the CPU can take only the digital information, that is in the forms of ones and zeros. So this port A can be used to transfer the digital data output of ADC. So ADC used to convert analog signal to digital. So after converting to digital, that input will be transferring to CPU. And port C for control signal. So always the port C will be used for control signals. Assume that an analog input is present at IP2. So let us take the analog signal is IP2. So then the address bits will be CBA consisting of 010. Okay. So if we are IP2 means 2010. So assume that the analog input is present at IP2 of the ADC and a clock input of suitable frequency is available. So this is a problem. So now we have to construct an interfacing circuit of ADC with 8086 microprocessor with the help of 8255. Now let us see. The analog input of IP2 is used. So therefore the pins will be 010. So whenever you are going to be converting the digital analog to digital, you have to make the output latch enable. The output latch enable OE and ALE pins are already kept at positive plus 5 volts to select ADC and enable the output. So whenever you are going to be activate the ADC, you have to make the address latch enable pins and output latch enable pins at a frequency of plus 5 volts. So whenever you make it as a plus 5 volts, the system is ready to convert. At the time of conversion, these 2 pins will be, means they all should be alert. They are ready for conversion. Next, port C upper acts as an input port to receive the end of conversion signal, while port C lower acts as an output port to send the SOC to ADC. So we have to convert first the analog signal. Digital conversion will convert the digital data. So with the help of only 8255. So the the 8255 is having the port C. In that, the port C port C is divided into upper and lower. So upper acts as an input port to receive the end of conversion signal, and while port C lower acts as an output port to send the start of conversion and end of conversion. So now the port A acts as an 8-bit input data port to receive the digital data output. So this is all the specifications for to construct the ADC to 8086 microprocessor. So the control word, based on that specification, the control word we get is 98H is the control word. Now see the program. Move AL, 98H, which is initialized. We are just now with the help of this. So with this step, we are initializing 8255. Send AL to control word register. So whatever that data that is 98H will be sent to the control word register. So for that, we are writing out CWR, AL. So first place the control word register to AL, which indicating we are initializing 8255. So then only you can transfer the data, you can send the data to CPU. So first you have to initialize 8255, that is a programmable peripheral interface. So then the ADC can send that data to 8255. After that, so now the 8255 is active. It is active. After that, we have to select the input. We are sending the data analog through input 2. IP2. So that's why 02 will be sent to AL. Again, that will be placed to port B. So now the port B is holding the data, which is sent as an output. The output of ADC will be stored in the port B. Now we have to make the start of conversion pulse. Given start of conversion pulse to ADC, and that AL will be placed in port C. So port C upper is having the acts as an input and the lower is acting as an output. Start of conversion, and first will be the 01H will be moved to AL register, and again place that AL in port C. Now the AL becomes 00, again place that AL in, means the port C is only used to make the conversion. It is used for conversion. And in AL comma port C. So after that, check for end of conversion. So whether we reached the end of conversion or not, we have to check with the help of this. So check the end of conversion by reading port C upper and rotating through carry. So rotating through carry. So if it is not reached the step of conversion, again you have to go here. Jump, no carry, again go. After that, finally, if end of conversion is reached, then read digital equivalent in AC, AL. So now the port A consisting of the end of conversion data that will be placed in AL register, which is an accumulator. How the program? So with this step, the CPU reads the data, the digital data in AL register, which is there in AL register, and how the program. So this is the how we are just taking the analog signal, converting with the help of 8255 and sending the data, digital data to CPU. And this is an interfacing of representation of ADC, interfacing of ADC 080 to 8086 through 8255. So this is here, you have to think that this here CPU is there, central processing unit, and this is an ADC, which is we are giving the analog input voltage, and the clock up we are giving. Here the plus 5 volts indicates the, here it is making 8080 active. After that, so these are the three address, port B0, PB1, PB2 are connected to ABC address. So in this diagram, we are selecting input 2. So now the address indicates 010. So that 010 will be sent to this PB0, PB1 and PB2. And PC0 contains the lower. The lower contains start of conversion and the upper contains the end of conversion. It is saying that you have to start the conversion. Whenever it is ready, it sends the signals at end of conversion. and the data that will be ready, that will be sent to port A. Then that data will send to CPU with the help of this data bus. And these are the addresses, two addresses will be connected to the CPU, which indicates to select the 8255. Reset pin in IO read and IO write will be issued by the CPU. So this is an interfacing circuit of ADC0802 8086 microprocessor with 8255, programmable peripheral interface. Thank you.